It is mentioned in the scriptures, even Christianity also says, the destruction of the human race will come if variety of food will increase. When more variety of food is served, it causes destruction. When we start living away from earth is the destruction. Believe me, if you are living on the ground floor, you live longer because the Mother Earth, you are touching the Mother Earth. And the food has to be a simple food. The day you eat chapati, you only eat chapati. And the day you eat rice, you only eat rice. But unfortunately, we combine both. Develop. In good old days, the Indian, you know what is the Indian food? It's very interesting if I reveal that. Chapati is not Indian. Paratha is not Indian. Curry is not Indian. If you see the scriptures, it is always the bhat is mentioned. If you see the yogi Agastya Mahamuni, what is kept in front of him? Heap of rice and dal, dal bhat. And even the muhavra is there. If you are unhappy with somebody, and we say, dal bhat mein musar chand. Masoor ki dal achi nahi lagti to, wo hai. The South Indian food, because South India was not attacked, it was surrounded by ocean. So the culture, the Indian culture, remained intact in South India. And there, now it is going haywire. Now it is all Chettinad. It is chicken 69. I said 69. What is 69? 89, 59. So all that, it is going haywire. But you must now adopt the Shiva Yoga way of eating food. When you are eating rice, you must only eat rice. Don't combine chapati. Because this, the let the stomach, let the gastric juices work perfectly on the perfect food which they are digesting. And if there is, first is aloo tikki, bonda, samosa, and then is chapati, and after we have eaten chapati, now the turn of rice comes. Now it is a confusing food. Please make it ahar, make it good ahar. And fasting, must do fasting. Fasting is very important and it will do you good. You must give rest to the body. Why we should give rest? Because when the body is not to work to digest food, then the body will cleanse, will detoxify our system,